Alright, hello everybody, we're back with another episode of Let's Play Pokemon Crystal with our Gen 2 type challenge of Grass type. Miss Goomba, what's strong against Dark types, by the way? Fighting types and Bug types for sure. I don't think Steel is. I know Fighting type and I know Bug type is strong against Dark Pokemon. That looks like that's it. So that's your answer. Fighting type moves and bug type moves are strong against dark types. Back to the top of the lighthouse we go. Let's get some potions really quick. I got some stuff to sell anyways. You got to the Voltorbs? Very nice. You mean the Electrodes. But same thing. Time to take on Jasmine. Let's dig. You missed your Thunder Wave. Good job, Parasect. That's one down. He's gonna send out Steelix next. We're gonna drop a Spore on Steelix. 100% chance to hit. We're gonna swap over to Ivysaur. We're gonna drop a leech seed on it. Alright, just a second, sorry. Alright, he did wake up, but that's not really that big of a deal. Our Razor Leaf will do neutral damage to him. If we get a critical, it's going to do a ton of damage. Let's swap back to Parasect really quick. Drop another Spore. Swap back to Ivysaur. And he woke up again. That did a lot of damage. But we did a lot back there. So if we get another critical hit Razor Leaf, this thing goes down. If we don't, it's going to be Bad News Bears. Especially if it hits with an Iron Tail. Bad News Bears. Well, he goes down to the Leech Seed. Back to Ectrotique. Lose Ivysaur for the next couple fights because they're poison type, and that's better for Ivysaur than it is for Gloom. Alright, we're gonna speed through these because these are all low-level fights. Hey, after you beat Team Rocket, Miss Goomba, don't forget to go get the Sludge Bomb team. Because that'll be really good for either your Weepinbell, Victory Bell, or Arbok, whoever you choose to teach it to. And it's available right after you beat them here in Mahogany Town. FYI. Accuracy fell. Not a problem. And to get that, you come up to this building right here, which has the two rocket guys in it that are trying to, like, extort you for money. And they're gone after you beat Team Rocket out of Mahogany Town. So you talk to the attendant in here, and he gives you Sludge Bomb. Very good. Alright, Clefairy down. And there goes the Lickitung. Let Gloom take on the Slowbro. It'll level it up to 32. And then we'll swap up Ivysaur. Take on this Nidoking. This will do neutral damage to it because of its ground typing. We're just speeding through this because it's only level 10 and level 15 Gyarados. Oh my goodness. There we go. Alright, now we're gonna go up here. Wrong way. Been a while since I've been up here. What team is this? Detect? Not what I wanted. I'm pretty sure it's in the house here. What's this item? Oh, Elixir's nice. Okay. first things first, we're going to teach Hidden Power to Gloom and hope that it's good. In place of Poison Powder. Then we're going to use a Hyper Potion on Ivysaur. That thrash really hurt. Alright. We always speed through wild fights. That's what the Red Gyarados is. Gets us our evolution, though, into Venusaur. Alright, he wants us to come help him, and we will. Swap our Weepinbell up front. We'll fly back to Mahogany Town and heal. Alright, so let's read about Venusaur while we beat up on these rockets. So Venusaur is a squat, quadrupedal, amphibian Pokemon with a bumpy blue-green skin. It has small circular red eyes, a short blunt snout, and a wide mouth with two pointed teeth in the upper jaw and four in the lower jaw. On top of its head are small pointed ears with reddish-pink insides. It has three clawed toes on each foot. The butt on its back has bloomed into a large pink white-spotted flower. The flower is supported by a thick brown trunk, surrounded by green fronds. A female Venusaur will have a seed in the center of its flower. Let's sleep powder this Zubat? Yeah. Venusaur uses its flower to catch the sun's rays and convert them into energy, which causes the flower to become more vibrant. The flower releases a soothing scent that attracts Pokemon and calms emotions. This scent becomes stronger after a rainy day. In the anime, Venusaur has demonstrated the ability to manipulate nature, releasing several vines from its back and lead evolution ceremonies for Bulbasaur and Ivysaur. This Pokemon is rarely found in the wild, but is known to inhabit grasslands. And our Gen 2 Pokedex information for Venusaur, Gold says by spreading the broad petals of its flower and catching the sun's rays, it fills its body with power. And Silver said is able to convert the sunlight into energy. As a result, it is more powerful in the summertime. And Crystal says, as it warms itself and absorbs the sunlight, the flower petals release a pleasant fragrance. Now, it's still going to be a while before we get our Blossom and Victory Bell, but we will get there soon. We're going to swap for Weepinbell. These are really low-level trainers, so that's why we're speeding through this. Alright, let's swap Parasect. I mean, at least the trainers on this floor we speed through. Let's get this switch. And let's swap back up Weepinbell. Take on this guy with the Rattatas up here just for the experience. All We get healed by Lance right after this floor anyway, so it doesn't matter what move we use. Alright. I'll do a bit of damage to Weepinbell, but it shouldn't be too bad. It is just a Venomat. I mean, if I wanted to be safer, I would Sleep Powder it. Like so. And then we'll wrap it. Good deal. Weepinbell's gonna be a powerhouse after we get done in here, though, because we're gonna get Sludge Bomb for it. Missed that rat. That's not good. That's what you do with an acid. Pretty good damage, honestly. You still have the residual rat damage, too, so that's good. Alright, let's swap up Parasect. Take on the scientist. We'll update our title really quick to show that we evolved. We're just going to keep Parasect up because he is not very useful against Pryce's gem, so we want to make sure he levels up again. She definitely should. There's a lot of trainers between here and Pryce's gym still. Good critical hit. Bad stun spore. Almost got it. That's gonna do like nothing. We are times four resistant to that. That's one damage with a critical hit. Get the jump on this Ditto by uh putting it to sleep and powering up this Fury Cutter. Well, I forgot to get the password from the girl. I need to grab that really quick. Alright, the protein we definitely want to give to Parasect. He is one of our main physical attackers. The other one being Victory Bell. Got him. 100% chance to put asleep. Grab Thief here. Ha, blah, 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 blah. Go to sleep. Good way to get easy hits on this on these Zubats that we're not very effective against. And eradicate. We'll send out Gloom. See what if we get an idea what our hidden power is with Gloom right now. Okay, well it's super effective, which means it's fighting type. There's only one type that's super effective against normal types. Fighting-type hidden power isn't bad, though. Makes us super effective against normal types, rock types, steel types, dark types. We'll have to keep that in mind. Could come in handy. Oh, it's really gonna come in handy for the next gym, too. That's funny. All right. Chabaka. Meet the Venusaur. Good flinch. Murkrow coming out next. We'll just keep Venusaur out. And we're gonna have a Gloom fight! We are currently in the lead, not only damage-wise, but status-wise. All right. Ha, blah, 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 blah. We'll let Venusaur take on some first. Since it has Mud Slap right now. Hopefully I was going to have it miss a self-destruct if it used it. But look, we took that on the chin pretty well. It only did like 35 damage to us. Oh, well, there it goes. And that one just took Gloom out. Lickety split. Alright, let's heal up. We're gonna teach Whirlpool so I don't forget. We need to go get Sludge Bomb. The most important thing to do right now. And we are going to teach this to Weepinbell. In place of Acid. We'll keep Gloom up to start in here. So we are super effective against each other. We have good stats though, wow. So if he doesn't rest now, he goes down. So he didn't. Alright, here comes the Dewgong. We're gonna stun spore this one if we can, which we didn't. There we do. A Dewgong has a bunch of HP. I don't know if we're gonna heal enough though to survive an Aurora Beam. Yeah, it was pretty gutsy for us to stay out, and a critical hit on top of that. That wasn't helping us. Good critical hit, Weepinbell. Damage on the nose. Good full paralysis. Swap up Weepinbell. So ice is not resistant to grass, it's just super effective against it. Good deal. Ah, it's so fast. Wasn't holding on to that, were we? Yeah, Jinx just hits hard. Good deal. We're not gonna learn Squeets it. Good deal. All right, we're going to use Mr. Powerhouse. Venusaur, not messing around. We will leech seed the dugong. Take an Aurora Beam. We'll be fine. Because Venusaur is a tank. Good critical hit. Same thing, we'll leech seed the Piloswine. Now Piloswine has pretty low special, but Blizzard is a very strong attack. Got him. All right. Excellente. All right, let's swap Gloom up. Let's fly to Goldenrod. Gina wants to fight again, so we might as well. Get this nugget, get this rare candy. Looks like Gloom is pretty close to leveling up, so we'll swap Weepinbell down to start these fights. All Good damage, but not enough to take it out. Should, though, with the recover. Unless it's gonna barely hang on. Nope, we got it. Let Gloom take on the easy one. Shelders and Cloisters have really low special defense, which is why this is an easy fight for Gloom. Now, we'd like to, you know, have a decent amount of HP to heal from this Cloister, so we'll use Hidden Power. And then we'll let it hit us, so it's not gonna hit us. Alright, well, I guess we're just gonna absorb then, since it's gonna raise its defense. Alright, let's swap Parasect up. Fly back to Goldenrod. Heal. And then into the radio tower we go. We're getting closer to getting Slash. I think we get at a level of like 37. That flinch was not nice. Go to sleep. Not quite enough. Got me. Don't have any super potions left. I just have a regular potion here. All right, we're gonna speed through this fight because it's just all the low level Rattatas. Excellent. A lot of poison Pokemon in here, and I only have a couple Pokemon that are really good against poison pokes. Put that muck to sleep. I know we can't poison it, but Sludge Bomb should do pretty good damage with Weepinbell stats. Yeah, look at that. That's awesome for a not very effective attack. Alright, let's take out these Magnemites really quick. Alright, can I dig out of here? No. Alright, let's go heal. We'll swap up Gloom. That's not really working out, is it? Let's swap the Venusaur. Okay. I guess that's a way to speed up the fight. Critical hit! Moonlight's not bad, but I like our attacks that we have right now. It's a good thing Weepinbell just does a ton of damage with Sludge Bomb. Start with Parasect up front here. See, I figured it would survive, which is why we put it to sleep first. We'll be right back. things coming out next. We'll swap to Venusaur. Drop our accuracy, we'll drop your accuracy. And that's why we drop accuracy. It wasn't a difficult fight, just prolonged. Alright, we've healed up. We fight our rival next, and he's going to start with his Golbat. We're going to put Weepinbell up front. Try to sleep powder it. Excellent. Throw them sludge bombs. Must have been a speed tie because it went first next. I'm glad we got the sleep powder off first though. Excellent, excellent, excellent. All right, we have Quilava coming out next, so we're gonna send out Venusaur. We're gonna drop a leech seed on it. Let's swap the Gloom. Do we stun spore it? Or are you just gonna go down to that? And you're not. But you are burned. So let's swap back the Venusaur. Gloom just has a hard time. Sometimes. Parasect comes out against the Magnemite. Okay, that'll do a little damage. Sneasel. Oh, I can just dig out of here. What am I doing? Go heal for Gloom's sake. Let's go buy some items if I can. We got stuff to sell. Nothing really. Guess I could have got some super potions. Mm-hmm. got him. Next guy's got a Muck he starts out with. Okay. Okay. I'm trying to just level up Gloom some here. Got me. Oh, see, now all these coughings, all they want to do is explode. You have a superior gloom against other glooms, though. Alright, we're almost through this area. Just a slog. It's not difficult, it just takes a while. I don't need to go there, I need to go back into the radio tower. Okay. See, that hurts. Thank you. Okay. We have Parasect up front, who's... that's who we want up front. I did that. I should just scratch again. Yes, slash, please. Swap up Gloom here. Alright, this is gonna be a hard fight because of the Houndoom. You can get the Hound down pretty easily with any power that's fighting type. But the Houndoom is gonna be more of an issue. In this too. Probably should have tried to stun powder. But we did take that ember pretty well. Oh, critical hit, Gloom, you beast. So, oops. I'd like to try to get the Blackthorn so I can do my leveling to level 40 off screen. So that's what our goal is going to be to end this episode. So we're going to run a little over our hour mark, but that's fine. This is not where I wanted to be. This is just a really good experience, these fights. Guess we got the hard one first. Probably could have took it out with a headbutt, but we'll just butt slap just to be safe. I was hoping it was gonna miss, honestly. Good poison. Unnecessary, but good. Thank you. save the day. Oh, that's not what I wanted to use. Blah 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 blah. Alright, this is gonna be an easy fight. We're just gonna speed. Oh, that's not what I wanted to use first. It's gonna be an easy fight if I click the right things. Okay. So let's power through the ice cave really quick. We got Venusaur. All right. This is the longest dungeon in the game. Alright, we made it. Excellent. So we're going to end our episode here. And I'm going to level up off screen to level 40. So hope you all did enjoy. And we'll see you next Tuesday, because next Monday is a holiday and I won't be streaming. Take care, everybody, and see you next time.